You heard the news, Victoria's Secret sold for $500 million, cause profits are turning cold. For years they've been turning some lingerie into gold. All over this globe, looking like stores might need to close. Sales so low over the past half decade, stock nosediving, 10% in the red page. And did you see it? Women's soccer was seeking $66 million in damages this season. Gender discrimination is the class act suit, filed and set for trial in May so they could prove the money the men's team is getting is much more. They play the same field, same sport, so what for? And check this out, man surviving a fall from 75 feet up off of a bridge tall. Jeremiah Crib was driving his FedEx truck when he seen somebody needed some help, so he stopped, no luck, cause another car passing was about to hit him in traffic, so he jumped out the way but went over the bridge after. He's gonna make it though, it's crazy but it's true. The jury's in, the people decided, the verdict's official. Today is the day and I promise this'll mark the end of a monster, Harvey going to prison. Weinstein guilty of raping these brave women. 16 hours of jury deliberation, delivering 2 counts, but some are left still waiting. He was not found guilty of a serious charge, but at least 2 of the 5 will put him behind bars. When the sentence is given, I'm bringing it to you live. If it will be enough, well that's something you can decide. This is the day though, the celebration of life. Kobe and Gianna will be remembered through likes. The Staples Center memorial is the reason. Thousands of people gathering, still grieving. Hurt as hell from it all, the Bryant to basketball are still alive in the minds of so many, and asking y'all to buy a ticket and go, cause the money's going to the Mamba Foundation that's living and still growing. Keeping the youth going is what they wanted to do. Did you see it? A young woman making history, y'all. Breaking basketball records, here's a list to recall. Look, 2,000 points, 1,000 assists, 1,000 rebounds, she found up at the top of a list. Yes, Sabrina Ionescu, bless you, baller. Some of you watching this might just even recall her from yesterday, speaking at the Bryant celebration, then headed straight to a game where she broke the record while playing. Oregon Duck captain congratulated through rapping. She said after the game, it's for Kobe, I'm here clapping. Let's take a moment to breathe now for the passing of the world's oldest man with a life you can't imagine. 112 years living in Japan, Chiantu Watanabe, what an incredible man. 12 grandchildren and 16 great ones said the key to his living was smiling, so let's make one. But wait a minute, there's a crazy story to tell. A 6-year-old was arrested for battery and was held in the back of a cop car, handcuffed, booked and released. There's a link to what happens next on YouTube that you gotta see. Peace. Did you hear about this one? The ultimate revenge. This man dumps woman cause woman wasn't so thin, and then the same woman dropped 112 pounds. Now Jennifer Atkin is the one wearing the crown. Entered the Miss Great Britain contest and won that. Says she never dreamed she could ever done that. She was motivated, made a goal and smashed that. Took the weight that she lost and said my ex he could have that. And look at this, Amazon opens up, a supermarket, no cashiers and it's blowing up. In the heart of Seattle, just walk in and you shop, scan the item on your phone, walk out, you ain't gotta stop, look out, cause what's next got me shook for the day. Don't wanna see a crazy headline, homie, then look away. This woman put a man in a suitcase and zipped it, said they were playing hide and seek, passed out and forgets that. Woke up in the morning, found him dead in the case. Says she was so drunk, that's why she red in the face. Facing a murder charge, wish I could said it was fake. You heard the news about Jay-Z and Yo Gotti, standing up for somebody when there's nobody. Mississippi Penitentiary just hit with a lawsuit filed by Jay and Yo, and it says this. They're calling now for the prison to close down for the inhumane living conditions and killings those found. One guard for every 160 inmates, and in this case people are dying quickly. Let's shift now to the FCC. Some people are going in for what they saw on TV. The Super Bowl halftime show performances received outrage from folks and it's enormous. 1,300 official complaints filed, calling it pornographic, rated R and defiled. In every single state in the U.S. say, except Vermont has protested against the display. But what a day for young women around this world. The first ever wrestling state champ won by a girl. North Carolina's Heaven Fitch just won that. Have you seen it? Love is Blind is the Netflix show that's breaking all of the records for the next hit show. More tweets and more streams than any this season. People have spoken up and the unanimous reason is this. Boy meets girl, girl meets boy through a wall. Don't see each other but fall in love after all. Reality TV that's hosted by the fill the shades. I watched a bit of it last night, I don't know what to say. It's crazy, the baseball world is woken up. History being made, race barriers broken up. The first black umpire, crew chief named, and the first Latino man in the sport to do the same. Congratulations, Alfonso Marquez and Kerwin Danley, celebrating big news. Wait, but can we switch gears to Big Fizz? Cause somebody found human remains in the den of a lion above the ground. The kid was 18 and been missing in Pakistan. A four lion enclosure, they found half a hand. The official statement made by the zoo is he was killed fixing the fence. See you back here at 2. It's news and Blake Lewis is the guest right here. I'm betting after we finish that the rest might cheer. And this week, never before has anyone ever seen Madison Square Garden do what they did for teams. 18,000 packed into the venue. To Kill a Mockingbird was the free gift on the menu. One night only and nobody paid. Ed Harris was the star of the history that was made. A chance for the youth of NY to see a classic. Done live for the one time kids, witness some magic. Speaking of magic, the biggest jackpot in Quebec was just paid. A 22 year old young man whose life changed. Bought a lottery ticket from the market he worked at.
$170 million.
We ain't rehearsed that. Amazing part is though, the young man split those winnings equally with his family. All of them win, yo.
Win.
Blake, we ain't done, bro. Still something to do.
It's only news.
See you at 2.